presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Let's go to Ben in San Jose. Ben, what's going on, brother?
Hey, Tom, how you doing, man?
I'm doing great, man. Yourself?
I just wanted to thank you and your team and everything. I've been using your technique with the 10-minute charts, watching the VIX, and just making a fortune here on the futures.
Isn't it interesting? That's awesome, man.
It's wonderful. Thanks, Tom. I appreciate
okay,
it.
Okay, man. Have a great one. Have a safe one.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. My dad is out. I'm filling in for the hour, and we got Apple rocking this afternoon to higher price. That's carrying the markets a little bit higher right now. We got the S&Ps positive by 5. You're trading at 5,085. You see the lows made at about 5,067, and boy, the market gets a gift today. As Apple, not going to be in the car business, they're not going to be employing 2,000 people in that division, and they're not going to be burning billions of dollars. That endeavor has been going on since 2014, 10 years. Finally, they see the writing on the wall. We'll get over into it. NASDAQ 100, you're up by 0.25%, above 18,000 yet again, 18,018. Dow in the negative territory, not getting quite the lift with the rest of the market. Dow off 132 points, just below 39,000 right now, 38,984, and you got the Russell up by 1.2%. So let's just get right into it, man. Apple shares, there's a run for you. You're up 0.9%. You're up $1.60. You ran more than $4. That news coming out just prior to 2 p.m. Eastern time. You're up to 183.92. 179.56 was the low at 2 p.m. Eastern time. You see a dip a bit lower. This is a one-minute bar I pulled up to illustrate the type of move. Didn't take long. Within 60 seconds, the market said, that's okay. We will stop spending that money because that is a long-term endeavor in terms of what they're going after. And long-term endeavors, when you're spending money, think about it when a company purchases another company, right? It's a long-term endeavor. In the long term, it's going to pay off. In the short term, though, they're spending capital. And that's what they've been doing. And the news hits, 2 p.m. Eastern time. Execs tell staff to wind down work on the Project Titan. Employees on some of the car teams are going to move to the AI division, reprioritizing. What is at stake right now as Apple reprioritizing in a big fashion? EVs, they are out. AI, they are in. 2,000 employees. They surprised them with an internal memo, I believe it was. The decision was shared by the COO, Jeff Williams, and Kevin Lynch, the vice president in charge of the effort. They told staffers that the project will begin winding down and that many employees on the car team, known as the Special Projects Group, or SPG, will be shifted to the Artificial Intelligence Division under executive Jean Andrea. Those employees will focus on generative AI, an increasingly key priority for the company. Can't understate that. They also have a bunch of hardware engineers and car designers. That's a little bit of a different story, of course. They can't quite shift them to generative AI. They might be able to apply for other jobs in the other Apple teams. Nonetheless, there will be layoffs, unclear how many. But that endeavor stops in an instant. Now, some of the points they talk about here, right? They finalized that decision in the recent weeks. It comes just a month after Bloomberg reported that they were at a quote-unquote make-or-break point, okay? They were thinking about pushing it to 2028 and then reducing the self-driving specs from level 4 to level 2. Whatever that means, all right? It's just less. I mean, they wanted a self-driving limo, man. And at some point in this, they're talking about, they had some grand ambitions, man. Let me slide up. They originally were thinking about, here we go. They started working in 2014. They set their sights on a fully autonomous electric vehicle with a limousine-like interior and voice-guided navigation. They didn't think we'd be where we are in 2024. I think they bought some of Elon's Kool-Aid, man, in terms of Tesla having a self-driving fleet of vehicles coming at you within a couple years, right? I think all of that kind of caught wave because even a company like Apple went for that endeavor in 2024. We're nowhere near where they thought that they would be on that car endeavor. Most recently, they were looking at a car priced at around $100,000. But inflation creeps in. And what were they worried about? They're worried about margins. How can they make as much as they want, even selling a car at $100,000? And they're probably right. When you get the average vehicle selling for $50,000, Apple's going to be a premium product, that's for sure. It had been thrown around that they were going to work with other car companies, right? They weren't just going to create a car company out of nowhere, but it was going to be an Apple vehicle. But they were concerned about the margins that they are typically used to. And they're probably right. Man, the car company is not like selling air the way they sell cloud space, et cetera. And they continue to invest, of course. Actually, not even that much when you think about it. $113 billion for research and development over the past 5 years. Annual growth rate is 16%. I say not that much when the company is valued at $3 trillion almost. And they recently launched that Vision Pro. Yeah, so... nonetheless, man, that gives a lift to the market. You got Apple shares. You were basically approaching 180 when that news came out. You're trading at 183 right now. That puts a lift in the NASDAQ 100. For some correlation there, you were at 1 o'clock here. You caught a low. The Apple news comes out at 2 o'clock when you're trading about 17,963. So that gives even the NASDAQ 100. You were still slightly in the red when that news hit. It's carried the market back up to where we were this morning. Slightly higher prices for the NASDAQ. We jump around to some of the other tech companies. Amazon, down about 0.6% right now. We jump over to Microsoft shares, down about 0.1%. You had Elon out there. Always nice to have less competition in the market, right? You got Elon out there commending Apple in their endeavor to wrap that up. Some kind of a tweet, whatever it is. Tesla shares right now, you're up 58 cents, trading at $199.98. And I think we got a caller. Jump over. We have Costa from Boston. Costa, good afternoon. What can we do for you, man?
How are you?
Good. I'm doing well, man. Thanks for calling. How's beautiful Boston? I heard you guys are going to get some lovely, lovely weather up there for late February pretty soon.
Yes, it's a beautiful weather.
Nice.
Yes.
Enjoy it, man. February. We're getting a little hot in Florida, but we got it made, of course. But what are we looking at? We looking at a little gold, Costa?
Newborn, NEM. I bought it at 33 to third about a week ago. Where's
a week
low,
ago.
Where's the bottom?
Say that last comment again for me one more time.
Where's the bottom on this?
Boy, you know, it's interesting how these gold companies have really underperformed, you know, even versus the gold contract, right? You know, this is a tough looking chart for Newmont, man, even versus some of the other gold equities, Costa. You know, I'm not sure. It looks like they had their numbers on February 22nd. This equity was trading at 33. It comes lower, and you've crept lower to 29.84. And, you know, even you back it up, February 20th, this equity was at $34. You're trading under 30 right now. I'm just going back February 20th, 1 week ago, right? Just for context, you go back to February 20th in the gold contract, and you were at, you know, $20 lower, $15 lower, at least at the same price. I'm not sure, man. That does not look like a stock with strength as it continues to trade lower. You know, December 27th, you're at $42. You're at $29.85. If anything, I'd try and keep your stops tight right now, because you see the slides. I know you know, man, but you see the slide, right? We were just at 42. All of a sudden, we're at 38 like that, and the gold contract hasn't done that type of a move. So they are dealing with some woes right now. In that equity business. And Newmont in particular looks a little weak, especially even versus some of the other equities, Costa. So be careful on that one. Find yourself a stop, man. Pick a stop. You can always get back in. We got some volatility. We got an upside coming, but put that stop in there, okay?
Okay.
All right. Appreciate the call, man. Take care. Stay tuned, folks. We're coming back with our man, Basil Chapman.
Commodities and bond markets are as important as ever right now with how they're driving the volatility in equity markets across the globe, which is why it's a great time to try out Teddy Kegstat's Tiger Forex Report. Teddy Kegstat breaks down the Forex markets every Monday using his 30-plus years of experience as a trading veteran of futures, Forex, stocks, and options. Teddy releases his weekly Tiger Forex Report every Monday morning with coverage of all the major currency pairs, including the dollar index, the euro dollar, pound dollar, dollar Swiss, dollar yen, as well as many more. And he also has weekly coverage of the crude oil market and the 30-year T-bonds, as they both influence Forex markets tremendously. When you sign up for the Tiger Forex Report, you also gain instant access to Teddy's 60-minute webinar archive he just hosted, Forex Strategies and Fundamentals, What is Behind the Tiger Forex Report. For all the details and to start your 30-day Tiger Forex Report subscription today, visit the front page of TFNN.com. TFNN, educating investors.
Are you ready to take your trading to the next level? Introducing Tom O'Brien's award-winning newsletter, Market Insights, your key to successful active trading. Tom O'Brien, renowned for his expertise in the financial markets, has designed Market Insights to be your daily guide to profitable trades. Tom publishes his daily Market Insights newsletter every market day before the market open, along with updates when warranted. Stay ahead of the game with Tom's real-time analysis and trade recommendations delivered straight to your inbox. Whether you're a seasoned trader or just starting out, Market Insights provides the edge you need to navigate the markets with confidence. Ready to join the ranks of successful traders? Head over to TFNN.com and subscribe to Market Insights today. Don't miss out on this opportunity to supercharge your trading results. Market Insights comes with a 30-day money-back guarantee for all new subscribers, so you have nothing to risk. Don't miss out on this opportunity to revolutionize your trading game. Head over to TFNN.com right now to join the thousands of traders who have already experienced the power of Tom O'Brien's award-winning newsletter, Market Insights, firsthand. TFNN, educating investors.
Are you ready to take charge of your financial future? TFNN is your gateway to the world of trading and investing. Whether you're starting out or scaling up, TFNN empowers traders and investors of all skill levels with top-notch investing systems, strategies, and techniques. It's time to protect and grow your money with insight you can trust. Join us live Monday through Friday during market hours for exclusive content that moves with the markets. At TFNN, we bring the trading floor to you. Our seasoned hosts are here to answer your calls and questions live on the air. Check out the Tiger's Den for just $1 and follow us on YouTube and become part of our vibrant community. And remember, at TFNN, we're so confident in the value we provide that we offer a 30-day money-back guarantee on all new premium newsletter subscriptions and services. You have absolutely nothing to risk, so why wait? Tune in live to Tiger TV and transform your trading journey, because when you know better, you invest better. Join us and experience the difference today. TFNN, educating investors.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Welcome back, folks. We got the S&P's positive by 4, NASDAQ 100, we're positive by 40, Apple giving this market a little bit of a lift, up about 0.9%, although pairing some of those gains right now make it 0.7% in the positive. To talk about some of the market action, folks, we're going to jump over to our man, Basil Chapman. Every trading day, folks, 10 a.m. Eastern Time, the Tiger Technician's Hour. Don't miss the program. And if you haven't tried out the opening call, folks, Basil's daily trading service, outstanding newsletter. Check it out under the newsletter tab at the front page of TFNN. You can hit the subscribe button. You can sign up for a month for $149. You can sign up for 6 months for $695. That's a savings of $199 or 22.2%. Or you go for the year at $1,195, you save almost $600. All of those come with a 30-day money-back guarantee. So if you're thinking about keeping that subscription, which I encourage you to do, give it a try. Think about the 6 month or the year, and you get a ton of awesome webinars with that as well. You got one from December you just did, talking about different equities, many different webinars in there. And boy, we got quite a market, quite a day. Basil Chapman, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Tommy. How are you?
I'm doing fantastic. How are you? I was just talking about to Costa, saying, man, you guys are getting some beautiful weather up there. And are you playing any tennis yet in February?
I snuck in a game of tennis. I could have played it outdoors or I played it indoors, but it is really nice out there.
That's good to hear. Nice.
So, you were talking about the market. So I want you to just say that you're absolutely correct. This is it's an unusual market in the sense that the leadership has actually continued to hold very well. And usually when you get these big spikes, especially after earnings, you get some kind of sell-off. But what I'm looking at here is, you see this chart on the left, so let me just show you. This is the Dow chart. On the left is the daily, in the middle is the weekly, and on the right is the monthly. If we go from the right, which is the monthly, we're in leg C. In the Chapman methodology, we try to identify the lowest low bar and count every successively higher peak, alphabetize them uppercase on the way up, A, B, C, D, E, F, G. It's at that fourth highest peak, D, that other things can happen. So that says monthly chart, only in leg C, you can't get a peak D for a few months. So that's very positive. The weekly charts, only in leg B, with all the, look at this, 9-period moving average way over the 14. Look at the 200-period moving average at 32,500. And here we are at 38,944. That does say we kind of overbought, but that's just a visual thing right now. The MACD is still very strong. Stochastic's fabulous at 95.53. This is the weekly, but there's a little sign here that says the on-balance volume is overbought. That's the one indicator I use as overbought or oversold. And it says, got to be a little careful. That's on the weekly chart, but it's only in leg B. That says you can't get a peak D for at least another 4 or 5 weeks. Okay.
Okay.
So that's the weekly. Now the daily. You see this, what I call the Chapman Wave inside track. This is this little channel. It's a repellent or a propellant line. So this pink line says every time that the price has gotten to that level, it hasn't been able to break out above the green line. So this little mini channel, it's a little tube here, is like a repellent zone. So we've taken a little insurance policy here. We do have long positions from way back in March of 2020, and then again in October of 2022. We've kept those. Now, what's really important about this is that you can see that the 9 period, this little green line here, is still positive. And as a result, that says for it to turn pink, in other words, if it go from green to pink, it would have to cross under that black period moving average, which is the 14, and it's got this inside track propellant zone right here. So a lot has to happen. So my thinking here is we don't have, at this point, we've got yields in the upper range, but they haven't broken out. That's usually one of the triggers to say, oops, the market's getting nervous. But we aren't quite there yet. Number two is crude oil is getting real. I'm watching crude oil very closely. It seems to me that I'm getting a number of very low-priced oil and gas service companies that seem to be doing very well. So I'm watching this really closely. Now, the other thing is, from out of the blue, you never know where bad news comes. And we just haven't had it. And that's one of the reasons why I felt that if we do have a pullback, and I think we're very close to having a pullback, it'll be more in the 4 to 8% range. And that's what I'm thinking right now. But we actually haven't got it yet. I do have a technique that says there's a Chapman Wave 2-bar reversal in the Dow from the 39,282 to slightly lower high the next day. And today's got a red candle. But these are, I mean, this is like an eye blink. It's like nothing. So I'm looking at it and I'm saying some of the technicals in the daily are not as good as the weekly. They start to deteriorate. And it's only this 914 that's still strong. So I'm watching this very closely because from the mix I'm looking at, I think that we can see that there's the possibility that we're bumping into some kind of resistance. Look, here's the exact same up channel. This is what I call the inside track repellent zone. Once again, look how many times this line, this pink line has been hit and it can't close above. If it does close above the green line, that would be up in the 5140s or 50s, and that'll be very positive. So that's what I'm watching. But so far, it's been repelled there. So I'm looking at this and I'm saying, for instance, we still have Microsoft from 338. We've also had a trading position that we took off. They took nice profits. In fact, we took profits 60 cents from the all-time high. 420.82 was the all-time high. We took a trading position. We took a little bit off at that 420.20 level. So it's still holding pretty well, but it's a sign here that says the upside's getting a little, it's a struggle at this particular point in some of the stocks. And then I've been talking about these round numbers. All I can say is that it's a work in progress, but look at this. This is SMCI. This is Supermicro, it made an all-time high at 1,077.87. I've had to make them gray because it's covering, I must have at least 10 or 12 round numbers, either at the high, the open, or the close. It's going to tell me something very soon, but it's so unusual you've got a stock at 850. People were paying, a round number 945.00. Here's 995. Today, the high has been 869.00. So normally when I'm looking at one or two of these things occurring, like ARM hit the exact round number at 164 the other day, it hasn't broken above it. It usually says to me, just be careful on the downside because someone paid exactly, they weren't even prepared to type in the the decimals, they've just been right there, 164. I went in, I went out. So you can imagine the person who's bought in at 164 seeing it go down to 115 in a few days. So I'm just looking at this and saying, the market is telling me that there's a little bit of hysteria in some of the action. And normally there has to be some kind of a pause, a breather. When that happens, as that particular sector takes a breather, and other sectors start to come on. So we're in very interesting positions. We've got what I call under the radar stocks that might not be influenced if the market does pull back. I do expect Microsoft to pull back some more. We'd like subscribers to get in for another at least trading opportunity, even though we bought much lower down, just in terms of trading. But we're in a very diverse portfolio, and I like the fact that the financials, the XLF, has done very well so far, and that just says to me there's some good infrastructure in this market, but you must expect some kind of a pullback.
And folks, if you want to check that out on a daily basis, check out Basil Chapman's outstanding newsletter. You can do it right under the newsletter tab for the opening call on TFNN. Basil, I appreciate it so much. You got Amazon in that Dow now, I was going to say as well, which is pretty cool.
I love it. Yeah, great.
Thanks so much, Basil. We'll be watching tomorrow, man. Have a great night. We'll be right back, folks, with Tim Ward. Stay tuned.
To predict the future, right? Like any endeavor in life, before you decide it's impossible, get some advice from the experts. You might find that it's not so impossible after all. For daily market overviews that give you direction on the key indices, selective stocks, and commodities, subscribe to the Opening Call newsletter at tfnn.com. The Opening Call newsletter is written by Basil Chapman, creator of the trading methodology known as the Chapman Wave. The Chapman Wave up-down sequence gives you an edge in identifying price turns, finding the peaks and valleys in stock prices. Get the Opening Call newsletter by Basil Chapman in your inbox every day. First-time subscribers also get a 30-day money-back guarantee. If you're not satisfied, let us know, and you'll get a full refund within 30 days of signing up. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Steve Rhodes started his trading career as a student almost 20 years ago, and the student has now become the master. Steve won the prestigious Timer of the Year award in 2018 and barely missed that mark again in 2019, finishing at number 2 for the year. An amazing accomplishment. Steve Rhodes is committed to sharing his techniques and knowledge with anyone who wants to learn. And he shares his vast amount of trading knowledge every day in his Mastering Probability newsletter. Steve's award-winning newsletter, Mastering Probability, is delivered every trading day with updates throughout the afternoon. Sign up for Steve's market newsletter, Mastering Probability, and you'll receive access to 7 of Steve's educational webinars absolutely free. At TFNN, all our newsletters come with a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have absolutely nothing to worry about. Visit TFNN.com and try Mastering Probability 30 days risk-free today. TFNN, educating investors.
Sharpening your skills as an investor is like getting better at playing a musical instrument. You have to practice, sure, but you also need excellent instruction from experts. At TFNN, you'll get advice and guidance from the authority in technical market analysis. And it's not just dry, tedious text either. TFNN airs live financial content streamed live on TFNN.com and TFNN's YouTube channel with Tiger TV, live every market day from 8:30 a.m. to 4 p.m. Eastern. For free. Each host is an experienced trader and gives their take on the market while taking calls and questions live from around the world. From the moment the market opens until the closing bell sounds, Tiger TV has 8 different shows with expert hosts to help you make the right moves with your money. Watch online at TFNN.com or on TFNN's YouTube channel and become the investor you were born to be. TFNN, educating investors.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV.
Welcome back, folks. We got the S&Ps right now up by 6 points. NASDAQ 100 up by 46. It is interesting, too, right, when you think about now you have Amazon in the Dow. Basil's talking about the Dow. Pretty strong data on the monthly, on the weekly, and you always want to have the longer-term trend on your side. That's like the wind at your back, folks. The longer-term trend on your side, you saw those longer-term trends. Pretty remarkable when you think about where we are on a monthly and a weekly basis. But when it's when a one-way trip to higher prices, you know, you put things on a weekly basis, going back a few years, you just take a look at the run we've had since October, and you got two red bars. And barely can you call that one, I guess, a top, but that's why you're in some of those when Basil's talking about his peaks, right? You can't have peaks if you get no pullbacks. And we've had no pullbacks in this market, which is absolutely remarkable, even on a weekly basis. You put things on a monthly basis, and yeah, it's just as bonkers. As this market has accelerated on four straight months for higher prices in pretty dramatic fashion, overtaking the B point in this market of 46.34, and you got a 1,000-point run from where we were in October. And I was talking about on my program this morning, you know, it's not often, I mean, check it out, right? You're sitting at 3,500 in October of 2022. Okay, we're approaching March. You're talking about 16 to 17 months of trading since those lows. In that time, you have had two 1,000-point rallies from 3,500, 3,600. You back off, you trade from a price point of the low of 41.22 back on October 1st to just 51.23. Pretty remarkable. All right, folks, as we talk to Tim Ord every Tuesday and Thursday at 3:30 p.m. Eastern Time, we have Tim on the line. You can reach Tim at his website, ord-oracle.com. And we're going to talk some ratios, man. Looking forward to it. Tim Ord, good afternoon.
Yeah, good afternoon. Thanks for having me on again.
My pleasure, man. I was doing my program yesterday, and I was talking about, you know, pretty interesting. I talked to you last Thursday, and we were referencing maybe Tuesday where this market will be. It's held up pretty well, man. We're sitting just under 5,100 right now. I got your charts ready. Where do we want to kick things off, Tim?
Actually, look, this chart one is probably the most important one right now. And this is the monthly SPX, or the Standard & Poor's 500. It goes back to about mid-2016. And what's going on here, if you look up to the right where we are right now, which is upper right-hand corner, it's a candlestick pattern going on. We're about basically 50% above the upper Bollinger Band. And that's kind of a, on a short-term basis, that's kind of an exhaustion move to the upside. If it's less than 50%, usually there's not a problem. The market is not really too exuberant, I guess you might say. They're going to move higher. So I circled the times going back to mid-2016, the times when 50% of the candle was above the upper Bollinger Band. And every time that happened, you know, this is a monthly chart. A lot of times the next month was a down month. And sometimes the next 2-3 months was down months. But normally you get a bigger consolidation. So what I really want to happen here is the market this month closes on, last day of the month is Thursday. So I want for this month, the month of February, to actually close back on the upper Bollinger Band, which is right around, actually I got the number right there, it's 4989. So basically 5,000 or a little bit lower, ideally. If that happens, then the market's not really overbought. We could probably still move higher on a short-term basis. If it stays here, then chances are March will be a down month. So ideally, if you're really bullish, want to be bullish short-term, you really want to pull back here over the next couple, 3 days, get around 5,000 or below, and then from there, we could probably keep pushing higher. And the bottom window is the SPX VIX ratio. It's on a monthly time frame. And normally, if the S&Ps make higher highs and that ratio makes lower highs, you can have a short-term consolidation. And that's kind of what's going on here. So I'd like to see the market pull back between now and Thursday. And it's kind of doing it weekly, weekly, not week as in day of in number of days.
It's lacking strength, right?
Yeah, so I like to see a little bit of weakness here. So if we do that, then March is probably going to be an up month. So we'll see how it trades out. So let's flip it to another chart number two here.
Okay, I got it up.
So the first chart, we're looking at the monthly chart. The second chart is the weekly chart. So we're kind of going down in time. And this is that ratio back on page one. That was the bottom window. The second window up from the bottom is the SPX ratio on a weekly time frame. And the S&Ps, if you look over what's going on over the last, since January, basically, the S&Ps have been making higher highs. Well, this ratio just flips sideways here. And that's usually kind of indicative of a consolidation. Sometimes they snap out of it and start going higher. We'll have to wait and see if that happens here. But if we can back off a little bit here. Anyhow, the market, what I'm trying to point out here, is not really set up to really go strongly higher forward short term. It needs a rest. It needs a pullback of some sort, kind of reset the market to build some strength going forward. And I think, you know, if the market's up every week, it gets overbought in time frames, and it actually, consolidations are actually good in that it kind of builds energy for the next, it builds more energy to the upside. So a consolidation is kind of due here. The reason why I flipped to chart three real quick.
You're making a lot of sense, Tim, even though this market just continues higher, man. I mean, and we all know that parabolic markets are a little dicey, man, and that's, I mean, these runs are pretty extraordinary that we're experiencing right now. So I appreciate you sharing this info. Go for it. I got number three up there.
Yeah, number three. So anyhow, so the monthly charts, ideally you'd like to see a pullback to around 5,000, a little bit lower. Nothing real significant, nothing extremely bearish here, but the market needs to build actually some fear in it. You know, Joe Granville back in the day, he said, you know, the market climbs a wall of worry. Well, you really define what a wall of worry is basically fear in the market. If you have no fear in the market, you can really have a setup for a devastating market. And the way I measure fear is by the trend. The trend is, definition of a trend is advanced issues divided by declining issues. Divide that number by advancing volume divided by declining volume. Well, now, when you do all that rigmarole, anything above 1.2, you got more volume to the downside on down stocks, and basically that's kind of a bearish scenario. But fear is actually good for the market. Anyhow, 1.2 on the trend close and above is when the down volume is starting to increase on the down stocks. And you would think that would be bearish, but it actually is bullish. I see we're kind of running out of time here. But
can you hang with us? All right, because I know we got a couple more charts. We'll finish this up on the other side of the break, okay?
All right, sounds.
Stay tuned, folks. We're coming back with Tim. We're on chart three. We're talking S&P. We're talking VIX. We're talking trend. We'll be back in 3 minutes, folks. Don't go away. If you're looking for potential trading setups in the stock market, then Rocket Equities and Options Report is a newsletter you should try. Tommy O'Brien delivers options and equity trades when the markets present them using a combination of fundamentals and technicals. Sign up for Rocket Equities and Options Report today with a 30-day money-back guarantee so you have nothing to risk. For all the details and to start your subscription today, visit the front page of TFNN.com. TFNN, educating investors.
Biotech is booming, but for how long? Whether you think the biotech bull has room to run or has run its course, trade LABU or LABD. Direction's daily S&P Biotech 3x bull and bear ETFs. Visit directioninvestments.com/biotech today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
The reality is that navigating financial markets can be risky. Markets can be chaotic and difficult to understand. Having the latest market advice can help you turn this chaos into a key for creating winning trades. At TFNN, we understand that it can be hard to find reliable market news. That's why each of our market experts offers their very own market newsletter, a must-have tool for every trader out there striving to find an edge in today's markets. TFNN newsletters cover every aspect of the markets so you can analyze the market before you trade. Try any of our great newsletters risk-free with our 30-day money-back guarantee. Just visit the newsletters tab on the front page of TFNN.com. TFNN, educating investors.
TFNN has launched the Tiger's Den. Hosted at Discord, TFNN has been educating traders for more than 20 years with live programming hosted by a variety of professional traders during market hours. The Tiger's Den, available to all tigers and tigresses for just $1 for the year. There's no catch or added costs when you join our community of traders. Sign up today and become a part of this educational community of traders. Just visit the front page of TFNN.com.
This program is brought to you by Vista Gold, traded on the NYSE American and TSX under the symbol VGZ.
Tom O'Brien!
Welcome back, folks. We got the S&Ps just hanging around 5,085. We're positive by 5 points. We're talking all around Tim Ord. Remember, you can reach Tim at his website, folks, Ord-Oracle.com, and let's pick up where we left off, Tim.
All right, chart number three. Like we said, Joe Granville, you know, to really have a rally to continue, you need a wall of fear or wall of worry, I think he said, per quote. And I always tried to figure out what's that mean, so I went back and actually used the trend to figure out when the trend is in a panic mode. That's readings above 1.2. That shows more volume is going into down stocks and up stocks. Well, you know, you think that would be bearish, but it actually is bullish. And the more fear you got in the market, the stronger the rally thereafter. And I got the kind of a short-term type indicators. Bottom two windows are the three-day trend. The next window up is a two-day trend.
Okay.
And normally anything above 1.2 in that range on both those 2 or 3 day trends, normally you're building energy for the next move up. And all that shade pink areas are when the 2 and 3 day trend reached readings of 1.2 or higher. So right now we got a trend on both of them just low over one. One's 106, the other one's 103. So we don't really have a lot of fear here in the market, and we got a gap. If you go on the chart there, kind of that blue area up there, that's where a gap is in the market. The bigger the gaps, normally the big ones get filled. The small ones a lot of times don't. And here we got a big gap. Comes in a little bit below 500 on the SPYs, which is a pretty good target on the monthly chart, because I want the monthly chart by Thursday's close to close below 5,000. That would suggest we got that the rally that started basically over the last couple of months could continue. If it stays above, quite a bit above 5,000 where it is right now, then probably March will be down, be a down month. So we'll see what the next couple of days go. It seems like short order here. We got today, tomorrow, or today's almost over. We got tomorrow and Thursday. And if we can get a decline, fill that gap and close there, chances are March will be a high up day. And also I'd like to see that the 2 and 3 day trend both get in on this potential pullback to get above, you know, 1.2 on average on the 2 and 3 day average. If we do that, I think we'll have enough energy that the gap will find support and the market will probably push higher all the way through March. We'll have to wait to see that happens.
And I know you're not forecasting it. I was just going to say it's interesting. The last day of the month, Thursday, we get that inflation data. So maybe that's an impetus to give this market a little oomph in one way or the other, and we'll see. But
if it gets oomph to the upside, then
out.
I think March will be down. If we get an oomph to the downside, then I think that would, especially if you get panics in the ticks and trend, Also, I want to point out, back on February 13th, on the volume chart there, I had a selling climax day. And that selling climax low has not been touched. Most selling climax lows get touched at some point. That comes in around 482. It doesn't have to be, but most of those selling climaxes are tested. Well, this one be tested, you know, there's maybe at least a 60% chance that it will, but not 100% chance. So it's something I watch for, especially if you test that selling climax in lighter volume. It actually would be a kind of a bullish sign, especially if you get the trends, 2-day trend, 3-day trend above 1.2. You'd really have a good setup for another rally that could last a month or longer. So that's where I am kind of right now. I'm neutral. I'm not real bearish here because I think the pullback will be done this week. If there is going to be one, it's going to be this week. And if there's not one, then I'm probably going to stay neutral because that would suggest March could have some trouble. Especially we don't have enough energy, which I call energy. Panics in the ticks and trend suggest the rally can continue here, not to the rate it has. You need fear in the market to fuel a rally. Right now, we haven't really had fear until basically back in, looks like, about mid-January. So we're due for another fear gauge here to lighten up a little bit, or to ignite the market, I guess you might say.
So sure, maybe a reason to give some.
I think we could see 5,000 on the S&Ps. I hope that area will become support.
Sure. So, I was just going to say, maybe that gives people an impetus to buy, as in a slight pullback versus sitting at, you know, 5,100 and change practically, as in a little lofty. I think we all see that it might be a little lofty for sure, reasonable.
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking. So we got time to move on, or you want to?
We do. We got a few minutes left, man. I got chart four up here.
All right. This is a weekly chart on the inflation-deflation ratio. And when the RSI of this inflation-deflation ratio gets below 30, as I print this chart, is 28.45 right now, you're usually at intermediate-term lows. I marked them all with red circles. And the dark red circles are times when we're going to flip back and forth here a little bit.
Okay.
Flip to chart number five real quick.
I got them already. We're there. Go for it.
All right. So chart five. If you look at the bottom chart on chart five, it's the 50-day average of the up-down volume. And when the bold areas on this chart match the bold areas on chart number four. So you got two different methods signaling the same bottom, so I'm trying to point out.
Okay.
So it's totally unrelated, different type things.
Yep.
Still pinpointing the same bottom.
Cool.
What on chart number five, what that bottom predicts, a lot of times you go sideways for a number of weeks before the rally begins. And on chart four, a lot of times the rally begins pretty much within a couple of weeks at latest.
And sorry, Tim, what is the bottom?
You got two different methods here.
On chart five, what is the bottom that I'm looking at again? I see GDX, the moving average 50. Is that what I'm looking at in the bottom there for chart five?
Yeah, chart five is the bottom. The bottom window is the up-down volume with a 50-day average.
Okay, cool.
So when it gets below minus 20, that seems to be the depth of that indicator. And a lot of times that's the low, and I have marked, I think, with red lines across the chart there when they come in.
Nice.
And so we hit there actually last week. Now we're still down pretty low. We're about minus 13 something. But we hit there last week. So even though the market pretty much hasn't changed much, it's making an attempt to test last week's low. But we also now got the RSI. The RSI is on a weekly time frame, and the 50-day average is on the daily time frame, but it's a 50-day average. So that's almost, 21 trading days in a month. So that's a little over a month of trading for that indicator to get down below minus 20. So they're kind of bigger time frames. One's on the weekly, one's on almost a little over a month time frame. So both of them are signaling a low in this vicinity right now.
Tim, that was nine. That was 20 minutes of action-packed info, man. I really appreciate it. Folks, that was so much info. Always remember, we archive each of these segments right on our YouTube page. Just search TFNN. We'll have this interview up with Tim right on that page. You can reach Tim at his website, ord-oracle.com. Tim, I appreciate it as always, man. Look forward to talking to you on Thursday.
All right. See you then. Thank you.
Have a great one. Thursday. We get it. That's the last day
of
the month.
Are you ready to take your trading to the next level? Introducing Tom O'Brien's award-winning newsletter, Market Insights, your key to successful active trading. Tom O'Brien, renowned for his expertise in the financial markets, has designed Market Insights to be your daily guide to profitable trades. Tom publishes his daily Market Insights newsletter every market day before the market open, along with updates when warranted. Stay ahead of the game with Tom's real-time analysis and trade recommendations delivered straight to your inbox. Whether you're a seasoned trader or just starting out, Market Insights provides the edge you need to navigate the markets with confidence. Ready to join the ranks of successful traders? Head over to TFNN.com and subscribe to Market Insights today. Don't miss out on this opportunity to supercharge your trading results. Market Insights comes with a 30-day money-back guarantee for all new subscribers, so you have nothing to risk. Don't miss out on this opportunity to revolutionize your trading game. Head over to TFNN.com right now to join the thousands of traders who have already experienced the power of Tom O'Brien's award-winning newsletter, Market Insights, firsthand. TFNN, educating investors.
Everything in the universe is governed by the Fibonacci sequence. This mathematical principle is responsible for everything from the most aesthetically pleasing artwork to patterns in the stock market. To stay on top of stock patterns you can take advantage of, sign up for the Fibonacci 24/7 newsletter at TFNN.com. When you subscribe, you'll get a weekly report from veteran day trader Larry Pesavento on stocks you need to pay attention to. And you can trust Larry's analysis. After all, he's got 45 years experience as a day trader. Larry will also provide daily charts, videos, and data on the key markets that he's tracking. Expect notifications from Larry on market movement you need to act on at any time. First-time subscribers also get a 30-day money-back guarantee. If you're not satisfied, let us know and you'll get a full refund within 30 days of signing up. Subscribe to the Fibonacci 24/7 newsletter today. TFNN.com, educating investors.
The reality is that navigating financial markets can be risky. Markets can be chaotic and difficult to understand. Having the latest market advice can help you turn this chaos into a key for creating winning trades. At TFNN, we understand that it can be hard to find reliable market news. That's why each of our market experts offers their very own market newsletter. A must-have tool for every trader out there striving to find an edge in today's markets. TFNN newsletters cover every aspect of the markets so you can analyze the market before you trade. Try any of our great newsletters risk-free with our 30-day money-back guarantee. Just visit the newsletters tab on the front page of TFNN.com. TFNN. Educating investors.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV.
Welcome back, folks. We got a little bit of a drift higher in the markets. We're up by 10 points right now in the S&Ps. We're trading at 5,089. You're back, basically. That's making session highs, man. Back to where we were at 7:45 in this morning, and you're above where you were right near the open. You're making session highs right now. With the S&Ps up by 10, NASDAQ 100 up by 43. You jump over to Apple shares, pulling back from that spike high, but you still gain $1.46 right now to the upside. Remember, you came into that news at 180, so you're $2.60 above where you were. Apple is negative already coming into that news. We jump over to Microsoft shares. They are flat on the session. You jump over to Tesla, up by about 0.2. You jump over to Meta shares, up by about 0.9%. So, folks, Direction shares. They are a sponsor at TFNN. We've interviewed our man Ed Egelinski. We'll be interviewing him on a monthly basis. You can always learn more about the Direction products by clicking on the banner or the front page at TFNN.com. But what I'd like to ask you is today we sent out an email on behalf of our sponsor. And, folks, you know, so much of what we do, the Den for a dollar and stuff like that, we're supported by our sponsors, supported by, of course, subscription as well. But we're supported by our sponsors. Direction has been a great sponsor over a period of years. So we send out an email today, and this is great information, folks. So you head on over to your email. It went out at 9 in the morning. So I encourage you to check it out, okay? And the email is exploring the risks and potential benefits of leveraged and inverse ETFs. And, you know, to support our sponsors, I ask you to go over there, open it, give it a click, if you could, to show support for TFNN. But you're also going to learn a decent amount about these ETFs, which is cool, okay? And what this goes through, when you read that, all right, you can click read the full article here. It's talking about leverage and how they behave. And when you go into that article, what's so cool is it shows you how these daily leveraged ETFs that are talking about 2%, 3%, 150%, what happens when the market either, okay, trends in your direction, market rises steadily. What happens to your ETF versus the market? What happens when it declines steadily? What happens to your return versus the index return? What happens if it's flat yet volatile? What happens to the index versus your return? So that went out at 9 in the morning. Sometimes it takes some time. Exploring the risks. We'll get that one. Exploring the risks and potential benefits of leveraged and inverse ETFs. So open that up. Give it a click if you don't mind. We appreciate it as always. And thanks so much for tuning in, folks. Stay tuned. I'm doing the 4 o'clock update, and then we'll see you tomorrow morning. Have a great one.